Being able to wire up a 13 amp plug at home is a very useful skill to have, and it's very easy to do too. You simply need a flathead screwdriver, some wire strippers, some wire snips or side cutters, and not 100% necessary, but it can make life easier sometimes, some bend nose pliers.
So take your cable and your wire strippers, just take the ends off, and then you can take the cardboard from the 13 amp plug, which you'll notice has the cable drawing for the lengths. So you just line up your flex in the appropriate place, and you take your live, which is the brown, and you cut that to length. Similarly, with the earth, which is nearly there already, and the neutral. Sometimes be a little bit fiddly. Now we take snips again and just take off the ends. I need a few millimetres. And then just twist the core together. If you have any ferrules, now's a good time to use them, but I don't expect any of you to have them. Right, onto the plug. So just open up the plug. Obviously you can use a flip screwdriver for this. I'm just being lazy because a flathead will do all of it. And also release the screws for the cable clamp. I generally take one of these out altogether and then just loosen off the other one. Just enough so that I can move it out of the way. So here we have the live, neutral and earth. So we just have to undo the grub screws. Take it almost all the way, but obviously don't take them all the way out. Do this for all three. Now taking your cable. Generally easier to start with the live. Just slide it in. And then do it up. Don't over tighten them, but at the same time give it a little tug just to check that it fits okay. And now then if you find that it's a little bit short or a little bit tight, you can take the bent nose pliers and you can just offer it into position like so. Like having a small child at hand to help get to those tight corners. Do the same thing again with the earth. Now the best thing about ferrules, if you have been able to use them, is that you don't get any frayed cable. So you just need to check that nothing's come out when you've done it. If not, you need to undo it, retwist it, put it back in again. Also, as a rule of thumb, if you're wiring this up to a light, for example, you need to change the fuse to a 3 amp or a 5 amp. But if it's a kettle or a toaster, then a 13 amp is fine. It also depends on the size of the cable. In this case, I should downgrade the fuse to at least a 5 amp because the cable in this case is too small for the 13 amp fuse. Once the cable's in, just put your clamp back on, put the screw back in, tighten up the clamp. Again, you want it tight enough to hold the cable, but not too tight that you end up crushing it. So just like that. Put the back cover on. Make sure it's done up. And you're ready to plug it in.
So there you have it. It's as easy as that. Please give us a thumbs up if you found this video useful. And until next time, thanks for watching.